This is a Selmer Clavioline, and it's a really early synthesizer that is completely powered by vacuum tubes. Inside the keyboard, there are tubes which power the oscillator, which is the tone generator for this instrument. The signal goes out of the wiring harness into an amplifier that's also tube-driven. So we received this keyboard from a client, and our job was to make it play as well as it possibly could, to give it touch responsiveness if possible, and to make it recording ready. So to lower the noise floor and just give it a really good vintage signal. In order to do that, we decided to completely rebuild the tube amplifier and put it in a new chassis. The layout of the original amplifier is inherently noisy. It has a switch that's right in the middle of the chassis. The signal wires go to a wiring harness that also has AC heater wires, which are very noisy, and everything's just kind of running all around the chassis. We took this signal out of the wiring harness, so now the keyboard connects to the amplifier with a quarter inch jack, and that means that you can use a regular instrument cable to connect the keyboard to a pedal, to another amplifier. As long as you have that wiring harness connected, you can connect the keyboard to any output that you want. The manufacturers of this amplifier really wanted a lot of harmonic distortion, because the oscillators and the keyboard are a little boring. And so to that end, they designed this really cool parallel single-ended 6V6 amp. When you play guitar through it, it has a lot of really classic tube character. We loved it so much that we might just make a guitar amp with this exact circuit. One thing that we discovered once we finished the restoration was that the speaker wasn't working 100%, so we put in a brand new ceramic speaker. I think it sounds really, really cool now, and it's a really functional, very old synthesizer, which is amazing.